Hanging on to cherished keepsakes is one thing. Compulsive hoarding, we learned today, is something far more serious. It's a disorder that affects up to 1 million Australians, and genuine steps are being taken to rescue them from squalor.
Few fans of this US reality show could appreciate a hoarder's reality.
Oh, God. Big damn rooster. How many do you need?
For hoarders, the answer is as many as possible.
People who hoard do so because they have an inability to throw things away. It's not necessarily a choice that they're making.
Twice as many adults are hoarders than suffer obsessive-compulsive disorder. Simply clearing the clutter sweeps the real problem under the rug.
Often because there's been loss in someone's lives, they're replacing that loss, whether it be a relationship or a partner, with something, with some physical thing.
At an infamous eyesore in Bondi, Sydney woman Mary Bibolis found each council clean-up distressing. As the mess mounts, so too does the damage. Unsanitary and physically unsafe conditions aside, hoarding drives family and friends away. Surrounded by piles and piles of possessions, hoarders ultimately feel isolated. Helping them takes time, trust, and a team of health professionals. New South Wales leads the way in treatment for the condition, and world experts meeting in Sydney are thrilled that hoarding may soon officially be recognised as a psychological disorder.
Which will open up a whole new world for the training of workers, for the understanding about the condition.
Jacqueline Maddock, 10 News.